Recently, I watched a Malayalam movie, The Great Indian Kitchen, which was released and nominated for the Shanghai International Film Festival of 2021. The movie was situated in modern Kerala, where a newly wed bride was adjusting to her husband's household. In the latter half of the movie, the men were shown to be preparing for their pilgrimage. The film charted out the compounding indignities that the bride faced in her unpaid and thankless labor that was exerted in domestic chores and cooking, the denial of her ambitions to work a job of her choice, and finally, the harsh isolation and associated untouchability when she was menstruating. The movie poignantly engaged with the news of the Supreme Court judgment and juxtaposed it with the lived reality of this woman who was not asserting, she was not asserting to right to go on the pilgrimage, but was fighting a much deeper battle as her existence was diminished by her gender. This is a stark reminder for how mere legislative or judicial intervention does not automatically upend the iniquities that are entrenched in our society. Even today, women struggle to achieve the most basic education and the right to economic independence, as they are forced to diminish their ambitions and thanklessly toil over domestic chores and caregiving, which society does not even recognize as labor that merits compensation. The Supreme Court of India may place an economic value on the work of a homemaker who dies in a motor accident to assess compensation for her heirs. The worth of her labor is recognized in her death. Societal change requires much more than a judgment. Homosexuality may not be punished by our statute books any longer, but society continues to punish them as they seek education, employment, advancement, and housing. Scores of members of the LGBTQIA community continue to live in shame, and several are still oppressed by Section 377 of the Penal Code, even when the Supreme Court read it down 3 years ago. Transgenders are still ostracized within families and seek out communities which survive on the fringes of society. With society washing their hands of someone who does not conform to their heteronormative standards, these persons are also excluded from law enforcement and are disproportionate victims of police brutality. Individuals with disabilities are often treated as unequal members of society or someone to be pitied. In a world as grossly unequal as ours, initiatives to bridge these fissures are not handouts. They are our modest attempts at creating a just world. Adequate